rise again.
That brother shall rise again.
Come on.
Martha said unto him.
Martha said unto him.
I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day.
I know that he gonna rise again at the last day. Read. And that's the part right here that's gonna shake up everybody. Read.
But Jesus said unto her. I am the resurrection.
Oh, what did you say, girl?
I am the resurrection.
And
the life.
I am the life.
He that believeth in me. Hallelujah. Although he is dead. Yet shall he live. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Read again.
I am the resurrection.
I am the resurrection.
And the life.
And the life.
He that believeth in me. Though he were dead. Yet shall he live.
Thank you,
Lord.
Now, you know, Shelly, thank you for reading that. Praise the Lord. Now you come on down a little further there, and you see where Jesus went over to the tomb. Praise that God. Then he lift up his head toward heaven and he prayed. But you don't say why he called Lazarus by his name?
Wow.
Because he was Alpha and Omega. If he didn't say, come forth, everybody would have got up out of the grave and come forth.
All right.
Praise thy God.
All
he
right.
had to call him by name.
Right.
Praise thy God. He said, Lazarus, come forth.
Uh-huh.
The Bible said he got up bound in bed, linen clothes,
uh-huh.
and got up and come forth.
Uh-huh.
Praise thy God. When Jesus saw it, he said, loose the man and let him go.
Yes.
This is my Father's child.
Come on. Yes.
Praise thy God.
Hallelujah.
Let me tell you something. That's the kind of life that I want to live, because it's going to come a day when he's going to crack the sky.
Yes.
And I'm going to meet him in the air.
Yes.
And the only way that I'm going to meet him in the air, I got to walk before him night and day.
Yes.
I got to turn in life. Praise thy God.
Oh,
he said,
yes.
Now, I am the light.
Yes.
Praise thy God. I'm the salt of the world.
Yes.
If I lose my soul, I'm good for nothing.
Amen.
But cast out in the outer darkness.
Praise,
yes. Praise thy God. I don't want to be like that.
Yes.
Praise thy God. I'm not here preaching to just to have myself free.
Yes.
I'm here doing this because I want to go home.
Yes.
This is my getting ready place.
Right.
Praise thy God. I got to get ready to go home.
Yes.
I don't know where my mother and father made it, but they're gone.
Yes.
But I know one thing. Buddy, I want to sing that song. When you miss me, don't worry about me.
Right.
Because there's going to be a soldier going
yes.
home.
Yes.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. It's going to be a soldier going home.
Yes.
Because I'm living that life today where I don't have to run and confront you to say something. I take back what I said about you.
No.
When I was talking to him in the office just now, I said, when I speak something, I can say it anywhere.
Go.
Yeah.
I'm not going to say something in your office and I can't come out here and say it.
All right,
I'm not going to say something about anybody that is going to hurt me.
Go.
Praise thy God.
Praise
I
God.
Got to treat everybody the same.
All right.
Praise thy God. Because
go.
Of the little thing, the internet, all he wants you to get a little thought in your head, Shirley. You know, he's been defeated already.
Come
he
on.
Wants you to just think something about your mother. It's not true. You get you that thought in your mind, and you can't do what you want to do. That's all he want to do. He's got to get a thought in your mind.
Right.
This mind in you is not the spirit. If you got something, you got to think about her. Praise thy God.
You're preaching.
Keep living the life of yourself, not nobody else. Praise thy God. You've got to live this life that you want to live again.
Yeah.
I'm living this life because I've got to live again.
Yes.
You're going to live somewhere. You're going to live here or you're going to live in here. Praise thy God. Let me tell you something, bitch. I believe that you're in the hell. And I don't want to go there. I really don't want to go there. So let me tell you something. It's too, this life that I'm living is too easy.
Uh-huh.
And somebody may say it's hard, but I'm going to tell you something. I find it easy.
All right. That's right.
they do. They didn't have money, Sister Campbell. They had olive oil, they had grain, they had food, they had pigs. They had to bring one-tenth of what they brought and give it to the Levite priest. They rise up, everybody had to do it. Even going down to Adam Tucson, they paid tithe. And I got one paid the right tithe, one didn't pay the right tithe. Right. You try to pay your tithe and gonna keep a dollar out, don't pay none. When you wanna be blessed, still paying all the 10%, put a lot of extra dollar in.
Yeah.
But we'll go to the ice cream store with $5 and come to church with two. Ain't I go? That's not being church. That's not playing church. Playing with your own money. You try to play with your own money, be long for you ain't gonna have no money. My Lord, I've been to me. I can tell you about it. You can get by, but you can get away. God's gonna run, could he catch up to you? When you need it the most, when your money run low, he let you go off. When you need it to pay a bill real bad, or a man come to repossess your car, pray God. And you need some emergency, and that man is going to take it. And if you do what you're supposed to do, then I'm never going back. Pray like God, I'm preaching something I'm living. Pray like God, I'm preaching something I'm living. My daughter Shirley, she told me, she said, Daddy said, come go with me. I'm going to look at a car. We went up there to, and looked at a brand new 16 model car. We got to talk to the man. I just stand in the background. Listen, now, Bishop, I'm a little older than you, but I don't think you ever heard of this neither. The man told us that you can, I'm going to fix it up where you can drive the car home. But she said, I ain't got no $10,000 with me to make no down payment. And nobody walks around with $10,000 in their pocket. You know what I'm saying to her? He said, I didn't ask you for no money. He said, bring Monday or Tuesday when you get it. I looked at him, I said, I ain't never heard such a thing in my life. But Sherry pays her tithe.
Uh-huh.
Even when she wasn't going to church, she put him in the drawer. When she was trying to church, she paid them all in one month. But when you pay your tithe, I tell you, dude, it's coming a time that God is going to pay you. But if you don't pay your tithe, you don't pay your dude. Shirley, when the man come and reproach my car, you tuck it, I went to court. I judged the man took my car. He turned it over, and he read the back of it, and he said, you didn't read it, did you? I said, no. He said, if you missed repayment, the man have a right to take.